Welcome to the Foundation YouTube channel. We're going to talk about nasodiaphragmatic breathing. We recently put together a newsletter that generated a lot of questions about this topic. So we're going to show you how to work on that and make sure you're doing it right. Basically, nasodiaphragmatic breathing is breathing in through your nose and your diaphragm drops down and creates a negative pressure. Your diaphragm is your primary muscle for breathing. There are also secondary muscles for breathing, which are the guys that will make you shrug your shoulders. And they actually come up and a lot of them attach to your neck. Problem there is if you're using your secondary muscles for breathing more than your primary muscle, then you're going to choose to start using those for breathing instead of helping stabilize your neck or perform their primary function, which can affect your posture and in turn causes pain. The other added benefit of nasodiaphragmatic breathing is that it's going to improve your VO2 max, which is valuable for any endurance athlete because it's just going to improve your performance. So we'll show you a drill to basically make sure you're doing it right. And all you need to do is lay down in a comfortable position. And what you're going to do is place your hand on your abdominals or right over your belly and then one up on your chest. And what you want to train yourself to do is breathe in deep, and it shouldn't be fast. It should be just a nice slow breath. And expand the stomach without raising up the rib cage this way. So again, it's here, you breathe in. And once you get to a point where you're really starting to bring in a larger volume of air, you'll notice that the rib cage is going to move, but you want the abdominals to expand first. And then the rib cage to expand. Now, once you get proficient at this pattern, or if this feels really easy and you actually want to train your diaphragm to get stronger and be more efficient at breathing, you can grab something of substance, something, some kind of weighted object, whether it be a couple of heavy books, a small child. We'll use a kettlebell just to demonstrate, and you place it on your abdomen. And what you're going to do is as you expand, you're going to really work on lifting that object up, and we'll demonstrate here. So I place the kettlebell here, and now it puts some pressure down, obviously. And as I breathe, again, I try not to move the rib cage. And I would repeat that for maybe a minute or two and then take a break. I think what you'll appreciate when you do this is that you actually do bring in quite a bit more air as you try to contract your diaphragm.